Yep, this is a 3D printer from 2019 running Clipper, and it is fast. I would say it is almost unfair what speeds you can achieve using it. It can be beyond anything reasonable, and I feel like recently everyone just became obsessed with it. So in this video I will talk about my experience using Riot Sonic Pad that supposedly offers the easiest way to Clipper and those insanely fast printing speeds. Some claims are pretty bold, so we'll explore the good, the bad, and what you can expect when using it with non-creative 3D printers. But first, a very quick sponsor segment. Love making all kinds of crazy modifications? Check out PCBWay. All you have to do is upload your file, choose from well-explained options, and submit your design for a review. It is that simple to get professional made parts. They have multiple services with the same ease of use, so make sure to check them out and get 5 bucks off for your first purchase with the link in the video description. So speed, suddenly everyone wants just more speed. But if you never dealt with Clipper, the setup can be, let's just say, a little bit overwhelming. That is where the Sonic Pad should step in. Crowd at the end of last year reached out asking me if I would want to test some products, and their Sonic Pad was definitely something I wanted to check out. So now when I tested it for a while, how actually easy it is for you to transition to Clipper if you never used it before. So the first thing that we should do is to download the firmware update for the Sonic Pad, as it seems they are constantly updating it and adding more 3D printers to be easily compatible. But what if your 3D printer is not on the list? Then you will have to compile the firmware for your specific 3D printer's microcontroller and make or find configuration file for your printer. This is probably the hardest part because the manual doesn't provide anything that will guide you in the right direction. So Google will be your best bet here, or is it Bing now? However, sometimes you can find even a manufacturer that provides a guide with what settings to flash with Clipper. But no matter how many different configurations I tried to compile on the pad, it never worked with the KP4S. The one that worked was provided by the manufacturer on their Google Drive. Then the Mega S with 8-bit board, and this one was a doozy. There were no problems with compiling the firmware on the pad, it worked, but the crazy part was that I needed to unplug the front screen from the printer before flashing, otherwise you'll break the board. At least it is nice that on Mega S you can put the jumper on different pins, power bar from the USB, and flash the original Marlin firmware source code using Arduino IDE. This allows software like Cura to see the 3D printer again and successfully flash Clipper, this time with an unplugged screen. The next step is to make a configuration file for your specific printer. You can find configuration for many 3D printers and boards on Clipper's GitHub page. An important thing to note here is that everything must be in one printer.cfg file to avoid errors while adding the printer to the pad. If everything is correct, the setup will be successful and you will be asked to check basic things like if the hot end and part cooling fans are working properly. So now that we have the printer working, it is time to make some calibrations. The first things that we can do are the basics like your hot end and heatbed PID tunes that allow for more consistent target temperatures. It is very convenient and easy to do it on the pad. But we wanted Clipper for more advanced features like the input shaping and pressure advance. So first, the input shaping or resonance compensation setup. This one is very easy to perform on the pad and the accelerometer is also included. You follow what it tells you to do and measure resonances for X and Y axis. But this is where things are not completely implemented. At this point, the calibration setup doesn't ask for the location where tests should be performed, so it just goes to a default spot. Yes, you can go after the test and chase those coordinates through the web interface, but in my opinion, something simple like this must be at the beginning of a calibration setup in the pad. And then the results. The pad doesn't tell you anything about them, and it's important because you have to set your acceleration values accordingly to what is suggested. Again, you can see and do that in a browser, but I would love to see the recommended information directly on the pad and at least the ability to enter the acceleration value right away after the calibration. And here's what you can expect with suggested input shaper settings compared to stock. It is like day and night. Ghosting doesn't completely go away, but it's reduced so much that it's almost hard to believe it is real. So great, Now we can print faster without those artifacts. But with high speeds, we introduce yet another artifact, the bulging on the corners due to the increased pressure in the hot end at those higher speeds. That is where the pressure advance comes in. But unless you want to guess a random number and enter it into the pad, there is no way to perform tests directly from it. So you will have to read the official Clipper documentation and do it on the web interface. Same with the extrusion rotation distance. It is basically your E-steps but with different calculations. There is no calibration process for this, but it's one of the main things you need to dial up first. Personally, I don't have any problems using the web interface, I actually prefer it, and the only times when I use the pad are for easy bed leveling or retesting input shaping. But for the product that is mostly made for people that never used Clipper before, I think it is very important to have the ability to configure the basics and the main features of the Clipper directly on the pad with proper guidance. So then, what about using it on multiple machines? Here I think SonicPad has the most value. You can hook up to 4 3D printers or up to 3 and a webcam. You can easily switch between machines either from a pad or in a browser. I didn't encounter any problems while printing but had some weird errors popping out once in a while. However, the build quality is good and feels nice. The screen is bright and viewing angles are great. My unit had quite a bad backlight bleed in one corner, but during normal operation it is not noticeable. So what about that bold claim? Can SonicPad running Clipper make your 3D printer speeds way higher without quality loss? Well, it actually can. With the old Mega S 3D printer, results were really nice. Corners were sharp and ghosting was very minimal. And considering how much time you can save, it is almost a no-brainer not to push for the higher speeds and the suggested accelerations. Results on KP3S were also good, but here we can see that printing overhangs at higher speeds are not what we want. Luckily, slicers are improving and Prusa Slicer has recently introduced in their alpha version the dynamic overhang speed for occasions just like this. And if you don't care about the print quality, the speeds you can achieve on some bestlingers is kinda wild. So overall, do I like the SonicPad? For multiple 3D printers and using a regular main cell interface, it is pretty good and it gives the most bang for the buck. You can clipperize printers fast and easily if you are a seasoned Clipper user. They're constantly updating it and recently even gave the root access for full control of the pad to advanced users, which is a great move from their side. But if you never used Clipper before and don't own any 3D printers that are officially supported, the experience can be kinda overwhelming. And if you do, then things will be much easier as you just need to learn how Clipper works in general. Basically, my only problem with the pad is that it doesn't have an integrated complete 3D printer calibration process for beginners who never use Clipper. I wish all this was available from a product launch, but hopefully they will implement that over time so that more people could easily experience Clipper, because it is pretty damn good. Hopefully this gave you a better glance of what you can expect from the SonicPad. If you're interested in it, check Amazon links as buying through them doesn't cost more and you support the channel. If you love my produced content, consider becoming a patron. Thanks to everyone who supported or still supports. If you have any questions about the SonicPad, feel free to leave them in the comments below. That's all from me and we'll see you next time.